Hi there, my name is Vlad and welcome to the channel. So let's say you bought a new TV or you bought a new monitor, but the picture quality is not that great. The colors look kind of washed out, it's kind of dark, it's maybe more bright than you would like it to be. Then this might be the tutorial for you. In this tutorial, I will show you how to get the best possible picture out of your TV or your monitor. Let's follow these few steps and you will have a picture-perfect device in no time.
This is based on AVS HD709 files found on the AVS forum, and I have been using this trick for years now, and all my TVs and monitors had the best possible picture using this method. So let's start with the needed stuff. You need to download files in the description. It's regular MP4 files and we are gonna use only a few of them. We only need files in the folder Basic Settings. It is generally best to find a picture mode on the display that is closest to a realistic picture to begin with. To judge the realism, watch some content with faces as well as grass and trees. Look for the most natural looking skin tones. Skin hopefully isn't unnaturally red and the grass and trees are not neon green looking. So depending on the TV model, this would be movie mode or cinema mode, and on some TVs it is also called the expert mode. So set your TV to this mode and it will have the most setting open for tweaking. You will then want to disable any dynamic picture settings. Things such as dynamic contrast, for example, should be disabled. Also, any picture tweaks such as black tone, skin tone, edge enhancements, noise filters, energy saving features, etc., they all should be disabled. Most of these settings will make the picture less accurate as they artificially change the picture, so set all to off. In your TV settings, you need to dig a little bit and find a setting called color space or color gamut and set it to wide or BT709 depending which TV you have. On the PC, you need to go your GPU properties and set your display to RGB mode and full dynamic range. Also, if you are using an Nvidia card, it is important to go to Video Settings and check Use Nvidia Settings and change this setting to Full Range 0 to 255. Also, if you have a setting on your TV that is called HDMI Black Mode, set this to Low as this will set black level to correct output. If your display supports game mode, it is a good practice to turn this on as it has the minimal input lag. This is important if you are using your TV to play games. Otherwise, if you are using it to watch movies, this is not that important. So let's begin with step 2, the brightness. First file we are going to need is called oneblackclipping.mp4. Transfer this file to a USB drive and play it on your TV or directly on your PC if you have it connected directly. Same applies for your monitor. Bear in mind that if you are using this for a TV, you need to copy settings for every input you have. So if you are calibrating HDMI 1 input, you need to copy the same settings later on for HDMI 2, live TV and so on. So you play the file and you are gonna notice that there are flashing gray bars on the screen. You notice that there is a reference black bar or number 16. So this is the pure black color, as everything on the left side should be black and all after 16 should be flashing. Not all at the same intensity, but they should flash. The brightness control determines the level of black, level 16 in video levels, and the goal is to make level 16 to be as black as possible while still being able to see all lighter video levels, 17 and above. These would be the ideal settings, so if you don't have it like that, time to tweak some settings. On your TV or your monitor, find brightness setting and start fine-tuning it to more or less until bars from 16 and up flashes. It is best to do this in the dark room so you can properly see the black color. When you set it to the proper level, this part is done. So on to the third step. This is the white level or the contrast setting, and for this step we need the second file. It is called 3 white clipping. Again, transfer this to a USB stick and play it on your TV or on your PC. This is the contrast setting. The contrast control determines the level of white, the level 235 in video levels, and the goal is to make sure that white levels are not clipped to maintain as much white detail as possible and also establish a comfortable maximum light output. It is also important to understand that on some displays, many LCDs in particular, that if the contrast is adjusted too high, white may begin to take on the tint of another color, most probably blue. So again, the goal is to set contrast to a correct level so that the reference white setting is white and everything on the left should have light gray flashing bars. So nothing on the right of the reference white should be flashing. When you adjust this setting, it is time to move to the next step. Step 4, this is the color and tint setting. For these settings, we are using the file called 4flashingcolorbars.mp4. Again, transfer this file to a USB stick or play it on your TV directly or from your PC. The color control on your TV or your monitor is an adjustment that increases or decreases simultaneously the saturation of the red, green and blue color components. If saturations were completely removed, the image would be gray. If the saturation were maximized, the red would be too red, green would be too green, blue would be too blue, and so on. The tint or hue control is an adjustment that essentially shifts the color towards each other. For example, the control can simultaneously make red more blue, green more red, and blue more green, or the opposite. With the file playing, if your TV has a blue mode filter, set this to on. It's okay if it does not have it, so let's continue with this setting. Adjust the color settings until the flashing boxes are neither too dark or too light. Ideally, the blue color inside and outside the flashing boxes will be exactly the same. Usually, color on the most panels is set from range 50 to 55 and never more than that. So once you have dialed this in, turn the blue mode filter off and let's continue to the next step. So the next step is the sharpness and overscan. For this step, we are using the file called 5, the sharpness and overscan. The sharpness control in many displays will be the optimum at the minimum setting, however, some displays will benefit by adjusting the sharpness setting higher than the minimum. Keep in mind that some displays may feature undefeatable sharpening or edge enhancement, and in such cases the result of adjusting the sharpness control may not entirely correct the errors introduced by these processing techniques. So, with the file playing, adjust the sharpness control to its minimum setting and then adjust it as high as possible without seeing the edges of objects turning bright white or curved lines becoming blocky or jagged. Ideally, you want to see every pixel in the source that is present. If you can't see the full pattern as shown above, try to find a setting in the display such as Just Scan, Screen Fit, etc. so that the pixels are mapped one-to-one and there is no overscan happening. It is also possible that the source is configured to stretch or zoom the image in such a way that overscan is created or the squares in the pattern become distorted. Most of the time, setting your display to a low value, no more than 10%, is ideal.
So if you follow this tutorial step by step, by now you should have a perfectly set up display. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. I will gladly reply to every one of them. And if you like this kind of content, please follow us on Instagram and join our Discord server. We love to chat with you. Until the next time then.